The Call of Duty Vanguard beta is here. You get multiplayer, at least on PlayStation. I got a PS5 here, right? I tried keyboard and mouse. I could not make it work at 120 frames while recording because of the Elgato problems and recording software issues. So I'm a little disappointed. I had high hopes, I'll be honest. I was super pissed off because I had really high hopes. I was hoping that I'd be able to play the game on a good frame rate and make it feel relatively fluid with like a keyboard and mouse. By the way, bad spawn system. Let's just bring that up now. Look at this. It gets even worse. Trust me, there's more. Just wait, okay? Just wait. You'll see more in the video. But I figured I'd make a video about the good, the bad, and the ugly. What I like so far, what I dislike so far about Vanguard, what I think needs to be changed. Mainly, okay? I think spawn systems are bad. Let's just say that now. I don't want to make a video just ripping on everything because I don't think that's fair. First off, it is a beta. Second off, I'm not on what I want to be on. Like, a lot of my complaints actually come from the fact that I'm playing on a PlayStation with a controller right now versus like a really fluid, you know, 200 FPS PC where I'm used to that. I like it. It's nice. Okay. So bear with me. Some of those complaints are just kind of what we're dealing with at the moment. Maybe next weekend it'll be better. Next weekend we have it on PC and we have Search and Destroy, which is like perfect for me. It's exactly what I want. And I'll be able to better judge things then. Now, you see me using a motion sensor as well in this game. I'm a little concerned. I hope there's a perk that counters it. I haven't seen all the perks yet. Maybe I should try to go through and let me look right now. I actually have my PS5 on. Hold up. While we're waiting, shall we? Perk 1, Ghost Fortified Low Profile. Training how to avoid detection by the enemy. Immune to the effects of piercing vision. Survival training. Maximize stun resistance. Okay. Forward intel. See indicators. Nope, nope, nope. Tracker. Nope, 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 nope. Tactician. Overkill. Unless it's counted in low profile, I really hope it is. Motion sensors are going to be a little strong in Search and Destroy. Not too overpowered in respawn, it seems like. Especially in hectic game modes like this, where it's like 10v10 or 14v14, whatever it may be. So, we can wait and see. We can wait and see, but I'm afraid of motion sensors. Just because they've been in other games and I know how they've been a little overpowered. And, you know, going back to like Black Ops 1... or the field mic in Cold War, whatever. They're a little strong. I'm concerned about that. I want to say, weapons, awesome. I love the weapons in this game. I hate the audio. I think the audio, I don't know if my audio is messed up or if it's the game audio that's messed up. It sounds quiet and muffled, but maybe my stuff's just messed up. Maybe it'll be different on PC next weekend. It could just be, like I said, the fact that I'm using PlayStation 5 and a bunch of new stuff and I don't have things optimized to be good. But I feel like the audio is really funky. Not just footsteps, overall audio. Overall, okay? Footsteps are just a minor part of it. But maybe it's fixed. We'll have to wait and see. So maybe I'm bringing that up too premature or too early. So I love the guns. I think that the guns optimizations and like the customization of it is great. There's a lot of ways to tinker with weapons and make them different. I really like that they did like a gunsmith style 10 different attachments, all sorts of things. I do, however, have a small complaint here with some of the guns you're going to notice. People are like, oh, the kill times like Modern Warfare. Dude, you must have not played Modern Warfare that much because it is really hard to kill two people at once if they're both looking at you. I feel like I can kind of do that in Modern Warfare pretty quick sometimes. It is extremely difficult in Vanguard here. Not easy at all. I like the kill streak system. I wish I could go down in kill streaks. I get a... earlier on this gameplay, you see me get a flamethrower, and it doesn't let me use the flamethrower, like use my UAV and then use my flamethrower. I don't understand that. I thought, unless I hit the wrong button, maybe, but I'm hoping that's maybe just a bug or I'm stupid. Because you could do it in past games with the D-pad, so I thought you could do it again. You couldn't for me. I had to call the flamethrower and then use my UAV after the fact. But I like the kill streaks themselves. I hope there's more of them. I feel like I'm a little limited right now. It's only like 8 or 9. I love the dogs. I think they're cool. I like the fact that UAV is 3 kills. It's very simplistic. I do, however, think Ghost needs tuning. I think Ghost is not good enough, which is weird to say. It was too good in Modern Warfare. You didn't have to move at all and you'd not show up on the radar. But I feel like if you stand still for even a millisecond, you show up on the radar right away. And I think it needs to be a little bit more lenient with your mobility. You know, like, I should be able to pause. Like, if I'm pausing to turn around. Oh, I was bad. Yeah, I'm stupid. If I pause to turn around, I show up on the radar. And it's like, yo, I didn't even stand still. I was just turning. So I'd like to see Ghost buffed a little bit. That'd be nice, in my opinion. What else? Maps right now, it's kind of hard to say if the maps are good or bad. I don't like the snow map that much. But that being said, I think it's primarily the game modes I'm playing. Like, I think this hotel map is pretty cool, pretty nice. I really dislike the fact that I'm playing 14v14 on it. That's frustrating as hell. It is so tilting to me. If I spawn and die, I just get pissed. You know? I'm not a fan of Shipment or Nuketown. You never see me play that stuff. I don't like it. So no, I don't want my cool hotel map to be ruined by non-stop shitty spawns. And I mean, you're gonna see some of these spawns. You haven't seen it. I mean, I've spawn killed a few already. Just wait. It gets worse. Alright? So I like the perks right now. I think for the most part, perks are pretty good. I think the weapons are pretty good. I like the weapon customization a lot. Maps, I don't really have a great understanding of if the maps are gonna be good or bad, just because I just think it's the game modes that are causing a problem for me, that are making it less fun. I'm a search player. I love Search and Destroy, always have. So, spawn logic sucks. The spawns are bad. Bottom line, there's no way about that. They are probably one of the worst parts of Respawn. They are shitty. Very shitty. So, I'm hoping, and they've already admitted that too, by the way. They said in a tweet, you know, we're working on spawn logic for one of these maps. This is obviously another problem. I don't think they included this map, but it is not very good. Not very good at all, unfortunately. So I would work on that. It's going to be very, very important for Respawn players. Not so much for me. Again, Search and Destroy player. Don't really need it that much. But very important for the Respawn guys. And I totally acknowledge, you know, I think the game has to be fun for you and me. It's got to be good for Search, but it's got to be good for Respawn too. A lot of people don't play Search. I understand that. My point of view usually comes from the Search side of things and the balancing of maps, weapons, equipment, yada, 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 right? I love to report that the fact that if you slide, it doesn't hold your aim up. That was an annoying bug in Cold War. In Modern Warfare. Not a bug in this game. Really like that. I'd love to report that... what is it? What other bug drives me freaking nuts in Modern Warfare? It's not a problem now. Can't think of it at the moment. Anyways, they fixed a couple of bugs. I like that. Look at this little slaying spree here. Look at the spawns, man. The spawns! We gotta work on that. That is... God, if I was their team, I'd be getting pissed. I spawn killed quite a few of them. And my gun, like, look how many bullets it takes. I swear I'm not killing them that quickly. I was one off my dogs, too. Shit, man. I could have had the doggies, too. I've been sick. But, I love... dude, I just can't get enough of the weapons. Honestly, I love the weapons. I feel like my weapon's really fucking weak. And it actually pisses me off. Like, yeah, my weapon sucks. But it's just because you can level up the weapon so far, and there's so much to unlock in the weapon by leveling it up, that it really matters to have a higher level weapon in this game. Like, to have the proficiency, like, you get not only 10 attachments, right, for every weapon, which is good. But you go under it, and you're like, all right, muzzle, underbarrel, magazine, ammo type, barrel, optic, rear grip, proficiency, kit. There's so much that you can do, and all of those things unlocked together give you a large variety of ways to treat the weapon. You can basically make any gun you want more long range or short range, which is great. You see me making videos like that all the time, where I take weapons and make them basically a baby version of what they were. And by the way, that flame knot went off. I died, sadly, but it was sick. Totally worth. I think that, the weapons are going to be a great part of the game. Honestly, probably the best part. I really hope that the maps are well balanced for Search. We don't know where the bomb sites are going to be yet, so I'm a little wary of that. But overall, I think we're in a good spot. I would say a majority of my complaints currently, my biggest pain points, the biggest parts I hate of the game, are probably the fact that I am limited to a PS5 when I had much higher expectations to play on basically a PC today. I was going to be on 120 frame rate on PS5, I thought. Playing keyboard and mouse. Instead, I'm on 60 FPS still, playing against people on 120 FPS, while not able to use keyboard and mouse, because keyboard and mouse on 60 is fucking shit, okay? In case you wondered, it sucks. On top of that, it's also very difficult because a lot of the keybinds don't work properly on console. They don't. Like, a console can't read a side mouse button half the time. It's stupid. That's a keybind I use. So, yeah, you know, it's a bit tilting. I'll probably play the beta more of the weekend, though. I want to max out some guns all the way because I want to be able to take this information I learned now into the beta next weekend. Next weekend, by the way, is on PC, Xbox, and PlayStation. And it is going to be with Search and Destroy, which is amazing news because Search has only ever been in two betas, as far as I know. It's been in BO3 and BO4. No other games ever include Search in the beta, which pisses me off because Search is always prone to bugs, especially experience bugs, man. They're like, I can't count how many games they've released Search with like the wrong XP values per kill, and you end up leveling up super, super slow in Search. So I'm happy they'll be in the beta. We get to play with it next week, and it'll be fun. If you guys have any comments, of course, leave yours as well. I've been submitting some bug reports to Activision, letting them know about things I encounter. One of which, for example, if you turn off the depth of view, it actually turns itself back on every time you relaunch the game. That's annoying. You want that off as a setting. It's not very helpful. So that's an example of a bug, right? If you got more, of course, leave a comment. I can't wait for next weekend, though. God, I want Search and Destroy, and I want to be on PC again. Thanks for watching.